dodo, dindada dodo do, dindada dodo,
dindada dong dong do do dong, dindada dong dong dong.
Hello, everybody.
Hola a todos.
My name is Taylor Gordon.
Mi nombre es Taylor Gordon.
This is nice. I like this.
Me gusta esto.
I'm known as the Pocket Queen.
Se me reconoce como the Pocket Queen.
I'm a little bit winded. I'm trying to catch my breath.
Estoy un poquito recuperando el aliento.
I'm a little out of shape.
Un poquito fuera de forma.
So if you have any questions,
así que si tenéis alguna pregunta,
for me, feel
para
free.
Mí, sentiros.
Because honestly, I'm trying to build up my momentum again to play again.
Construir mi momento, lo que voy a tocar. ¿Tenéis alguna pregunta?
I love you.
Os quiero a todos. ¿Alguna pregunta? Any questions? Wait a second. No veo. ¿Se puede encender la sala un poco? Ahí va. ¿Quién quería preguntar? ¿Queréis preguntar algo? No hay preguntas.
Okay.
Por ahora, okay.
So for people who don't know me,
para la gente que no me conoce,
I will give you a bit of my background.
Os diré un poquito de mis antecedentes.
I started playing drums.
Empecé a tocar la batería
at a very young age.
Cuando era muy pequeña. Go on.
I started playing. Okay, I said that already.
Yeah. Don't mind me.
My first love and passion.
Amor y pasión.
Before drums.
Antes que la batería.
Is music.
Es la música.
And I am a soul believer.
Y soy una creyente del alma.
In playing for the music.
En tocar para la música.
And that is where I got my name from.
Y ese es de donde yo saqué, conseguí mi nombre.
The Pocket Queen.
The Pocket Queen, la reina del pocket.
Because
ya que
I think the most important thing about music
importante acerca de la música
is feeling.
El feeling.
It is what connects us.
Es lo que nos conecta.
We can all feel happiness.
Todos podemos sentir la felicidad.
We can all feel sadness.
Podemos sentir la tristeza.
And joy.
Y la alegría.
And this is a tool
es una herramienta para
bring about those
traer
emotions.
Todas esas emociones.
With that being said,
habiendo dicho ya eso,
I'm going to move to my next tune,
voy a empezar mi próxima canción,
which is entitled Full Circle.
Se titula Full Circle.
It is by an amazing composer.
Es un compositor increíble
named Nico,
que se llama Nico
Ilasi.
Ilasi.
I am playing on this record.
Estoy tocando en este disco.
When it comes out,
cuando salga,
Nicolective, Volume 2,
al volumen 2 de Nicolective.
Be on the lookout for that.
Así que habrá que buscarlo. Hay que interesarse.
Am I going too slow?
No, you're going fine.
Okay, all right. Cool. I'm just making sure. Here I go.
Aquí vamos. Taylor Gordon. Thank you.
it would be extremely cool to take that first series of chords from the beginning of the song, that first groove, and we can make it sound more like 2017, 2018, like it's from today, you know what I mean? It's, make it sound more like pop trappy, pop trappy, pop, 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 pop trappy. Woo!
Thank you
so much.
That piece in particular,
esa pieza de música en particular,
is a favorite of mine because
una de mis favoritas porque
of its grooviness, of course, the pocket.
Por supuesto, es groovy, está ahí el pocket.
But listening back to it, I feel like I played
escucho,
this differently
toco, que veo que la toco diferente
when I recorded the record.
Que cuando grabé el disco.
And listening back to my own recording,
a mi propia grabación,
I found that less was more.
Me di cuenta que el menos
and I think
más,
that happens a lot.
Que eso pasa mucho.
As a musician, we listen
como
back
músico,
to our playing and analyze.
Lo que hemos tocado y lo analizamos,
and we often find
nos damos cuenta
that if we give room for the music
que
to
si
breathe,
dejamos sitio para que la música respire,
it allows your instrument to serve
que tu
its true purpose.
Sirva su propósito.
And serve the music.
Y sirva la música.
At least that's what I think I did today.
Es lo que creo que
that, that was my intention.
Esa fue mi intención.
But there were a lot of adjustments that I made as far as my patterns and dynamics.
A los patrones, a las dinámicas.
And I think with the tempered instrument as such as the drum set, it can be
instrumento
easy
como la batería puede ser muy fácil
to forget that, to forget how important that is.
Olvidar lo importante que es.
When acting as
cuando
a musician in a composition.
En una composición.
So a lot of the music that
así
I will be playing today,
que voy a tocar hoy,
not only is groovy,
no solo es groovy,
but it's musical.
Pero musical también.
And with that, I think musicality
que la musicalidad
is one of the most
es una
fundamental
de las más importantes
elements
fundamentales,
of my playing.
Elementos fundamentales en mi forma de tocar.
And yeah, at this time, if there are any questions, just feel free to raise your hand.
Si alguna pregunta, por favor, levantar la mano y sentiros libre de hacerla. ¿Alguna pregunta? Sí, ok. Una pregunta allá arriba.
Hola.
Hola.
Perdona mi franco castellano. Quería preguntar cómo Taylor ha escogido sus platos, porque son preciosos, y que describiese por qué los ha escogido y que demuestre un poco más el sonido del wash del right, porque es precioso. Gracias.
He'd like to know how do you pick your cymbals. How you make them sound so beautifully, they sound really wonderful. If you can go further explaining each one of the sounds and also play the stack, the wash.
Sure.
So why you pick those cymbals in particular?
Yes, okay. I used the brand Paiste.
Yo tenía, solía tener Paiste, la marca.
Which is mostly known for their bright sounds.
Conocido por su sonido brillante.
But all of the cymbals today that I have picked are very in the middle. I don't necessarily like too bright of sounds.
Quiero el sonido demasiado brillante,
and I also don't like too dark of sounds.
Me gusta demasiado oscuro.
So I'll just start immediately to my left, starting with the stack.
Desde el lado izquierdo, el stack.
This is a 14-inch
plato de 14 pulgadas.
Peisty PXT.
PST.
And I have two of them stacked on top of each other.
Dos, uno encima del otro en stack.
Which creates a nice trashy sound, and it's great for effects and accents. And my hi-hat choice for today is the Peisty Master series, a 14-inch, and it is entitled a Dark Hi-Hat. And what I love most about these is that it's not harsh to the ear, but it's
muy duro para el oído.
But it's still crisp.
Pero tiene su crisp.
It cuts through,
and
you can hear mostly every note that I'm playing
cada nota prácticamente que toco,
without it being too annoying to the ear.
Demasiado molesto para el oído.
And I think that is an important element to pay attention to
para prestar atención
when picking out cymbals.
Cuando eligen los platos.
And really, what I try to do is match
lo que yo intento hacer es emparejar
whatever cymbals I'm playing to whatever song
que estoy
I'm playing.
Para la canción que voy a tocar.
Because oftentimes it does add to the composition to have the correct sounding cymbals.
Es importante para la composición tener los platos correctos.
My crash is a Peisty Masters.
Peisty Master, de la serie Master.
Dark crash.
Dark crash.
17-inch.
De 17 pulgadas.
My splash.
Mi splash.
Is a Peisty Formula 602.
Es un Formula 602 de.
And it's an 8-inch.
De 8 pulgadas.
I believe this particular splash
was designed splash en particular fue diseñado
by Vinny Caliuta.
Por Vinny Caliuta.
And he made it
hizo,
so that it was a space in between the bright sounds and the dark sounds,
entre los
which is why
oscuro,
I really love this line of cymbals. Formula 602 is highly recommended for
muy recomendada
any pop
cualquier estilo
playing
pop.
Or it's multi-genre. It's a very versatile cymbal. I personally like darker sounding
rides.
So I have a
Peisty
traditional signature. I'm not exactly sure. I think it's because it's not written right here. They just have Peisty. But it's a signature traditional.
Creo que es un signature traditional.
It's pretty thin.
Es bastante fino.
Which gives me a nice wash if I want to crash on it.
Bastante bueno cuando quiero
I think it's important that wherever I want to crash, I can crash.
Donde yo pueda hacer un crash lo puedo hacer.
But also, it's a great ride in general.
Plato como ride en general muy bueno.
And to my right,
y a la derecha del todo,
I have
de
the Peisty,
Peisty
Masters
Master,
Dark Crash,
18-inch.
De 18
pulgadas.
And it just gives just enough contrast between my two crashes,
entre los dos crashes,
but it makes it ultimately bigger when I crash on both of them.
Últimamente muy cálido, muy bueno cuando lo golpeas juntos.
I hope this has answered your question.
Espero que haya respondido a tu pregunta.
Any more?
¿Alguna otra pregunta?
Please.
¿Alguien por allí? He visto levantar una paqueta. Okay.
Con respecto a lo de la musicalidad, cuando tienes que construir una parte de transición en una canción en la que solo suena la batería, ¿qué recomendaría para construir partes que tengan musicalidad y que acompañen la canción y no sean solo?
Regarding musicality. How would you prepare a drum part when you're drumming in a transition of a song, but you don't have the music really?
Tocando solo con la claqueta, por ejemplo, en un estudio, like if you were in a setting of recording with only with a click, how would you make a transition? What type of musical ideas would you advise?
If I were in transition of
the
what?
Transition of a song,
okay.
One. From chorus to verse or whatever, and then you only have a click. You don't have many musical references.
Oh, you only have a click. There's no music.
Sin música.
Sí, lo que quiero decir es una parte en la que solo suena la batería, ¿no?
In a part that you only have drum part, only drum sounds. So, como un solo, ¿no? Una especie.
Sí, como si fuese una especie de solo para que no se pierda la musicalidad de la canción, ¿no? Y con.
No, it's almost like playing a solo, so the musicality of the song is not lost.
So Is it going to turn into a song?
Pero se va a convertir en una canción o es la parte de la canción que ya está.
Es una parte entre partes.
It's a part of the song already. I mean, the song has a part where the drum is featuring, and then you play something musical. How would you develop that idea from scratch?
And you play something musical. I'm so sorry. Lo siento. I'm just trying to understand. So there's a part.
Yeah, the part of the song has only drums. And how would you develop ideas that would be very musical for the part? Would you be busy, open?
Most of the time, I would say my approach is never to be busy. My approach is more so to, if it is drums, I even try to relate my drums to melody. I try to think of a melody and play around with it. Because the main purpose is when I play the drums, I want people to hear music at least in their heads.
La música en su cabeza, como mínimo.
I want them to be able to compose from my drumming.
Que compongan desde mi batería.
So I think ultimately it will increase your musicality.
Podría aumentar la musicalidad.
If you're thinking about music itself and melodies
en vez de,
and bass lines
en línea de bajo,
and
melodías,
grooves or
y grooves.
I think really just feelings,
sobre todo.
I think that I hope that's helpful.
Creo que eso espero que te ayude. Espero que te sirva. ¿Alguna otra pregunta?
¿Qué tal? Bueno, después de googlear el nombre de Taylor y que me salgan 200 noticias de Taylor Swift, quería saber si le habían ofrecido colaborar con algún artista grande, ya que eso sería un lanzamiento para cualquier batería. Y si ya ha colaborado, lo siento, porque no lo he encontrado. No lo he visto.
He googled you, and he found thousands of Taylor Swift instead of Taylor Gordon. So he's wondering, I mean, he couldn't find you, so he's wondering if you have been playing with major artists, and who have you been playing with? What is...
Yes, I've been blessed with the opportunity to play with a number of major artists. I guess people talk about me doing the Super Bowl with Beyoncé.
Gente cuando toqué con Beyoncé en el Super Bowl.
Which I wasn't playing
más de 100 millones de personas,
the drums. I was playing a snare drum and I was
una caja de marching,
accompanied by a marching band.
Acompañando a una banda de
I was
marching.
In the front.
Ella estaba delante del todo, si lo buscáis lo veréis en YouTube.
Yeah, I've toured. It's hard for me to like really name all the people.
I'm not really good at name dropping.
I don't really do that a lot.
But he tocado, pero
I've toured and
con,
right now,
ahora mismo,
I think a lot of the exposure that I've been getting has been from my social media presence.
De su presencia en los medios, en la media, en los,
for people
las redes
who
sociales.
Aren't following me and are interested in my social media pages,
en mis páginas de
I can be found as the Pocket
media.
Queen.
Encontrar como the Pocket Queen.
At the Pocket Queen.
Arroba the Pocket Queen.
On Instagram and
en
Facebook.
Instagram and Facebook.
And YouTube.
And YouTube.
And that content, I am playing majority covers
of
songs that I
covers
like.
De canciones que me gustan.
And most recently, I have been working on my own solo project.
En mi proyecto solo.
So, yeah, that's why I'm here, folks.
Por eso, por lo que estoy aquí, amigos.
Cool. With that being said, I feel like I'm using so much time talking. Wow. I'm going to move on to the next piece, which is also by Nico Yalasi. It is called Onward and Upward.
Se llama Onward and Upward.
And I remember before recording this song, I felt such a deep connection to it because I felt like there was something very spiritual about it. I'm a strong believer in God.
Soy una gran creyente, una ferviente creyente en Dios.
And I try my best to be as sensitive to his spirit when I play.
A su espíritu cuando toco.
And I feel like when I listen to the song, it
canción,
just really hit me. I really like playing
toca.
Songs that
me gustan las canciones
make me feel
que
good
me hacen sentir.
And bring out a sort of joy in me. And this is one of those songs.
I
hope it does the same for you.
Alegría. Y espero que te suceda
Here we
a ti
go.
También.
Stop talking.
Aquí vamos. Taylor Gordon, The Pocket Queen.
Thank you.
This is the Tam Tam Fest.
Este es el Drum Fest de Tam Tam.
I'm so thankful to Tama.
Estoy muy agradecida a Tama
for making me a part of their roster recently.
Parte de su roster de artistas recientemente.
And I absolutely love the sound of these drums. I don't know if you all agree.
Me encanta el sonido de esta batería. No sé si estáis de acuerdo.
But
pero
I love the fullness of them.
Me encanta la redondez, la grandeza de ellas, de esta batería.
This particular kit is made out of
este kit
walnut,
está hecho de walnut
and birch.
Y birch, abedul.
The walnut birch kit.
Es el walnut birch kit.
And what I love most about it is that it is
este
warm,
es muy cálido,
and also
también,
it cracks.
Y también crack, tiene fuerza.
I love sounds that contrast each other. I love things that contrast each other. And this particular drum
set
allows my sound to sound warm,
cálido,
but at the same time very aggressive,
tiempo, muy agresivo,
without having to do too much work.
Hacer demasiado trabajo.
And yeah, are there any more
¿Hay alguna
questions?
Otra pregunta? Sí, a ver.
Por aquí.
Venga.
Más abajo. Bueno, a tu izquierda. Jesús. Bueno. La pregunta era, yo la sigo en Instagram de hace un par de años y era preguntarle cómo ha afectado, bueno, cómo ha servido la plataforma Instagram para ella, para su carrera, y si la usa de una manera más personal o una manera más profesional.
He's following you in Instagram and he's wondering how that affects you, your career, if you use it more on a personal level, professional level, both, how that affects you and what do you think of that?
Before I started posting
videos,
I had just gotten off tour.
Estaba dentro de una gira.
And I was left in the predicament of worrying about what my next job would be.
Y estaba preguntándome cuál sería mi próximo trabajo.
And I know that's a familiar feeling to any touring or gigging musician.
Familiar para músicos cuando están de gira o haciendo bolos.
I found myself very frustrated with that.
Yo me sentía muy frustrada con eso.
And it just so happens that after a failed audition,
que cuando yo hice una audición, cuando fallé,
I tried out for another tour and I didn't get it.
Otra gira y no la conseguí.
I decided to go to my practice room
ir a mi cuarto de prácticas, a mi local de ensayo,
and play to a song that I had never really learned the drum
que
pattern
nunca había
to.
Aprendido la parte de la batería.
And that
y eso,
action,
esa acción,
changed my career,
cambió mi carrera.
And it brought all the work to me.
Y cambió significó todo para mí.
And that is because I think
y eso es porque creo
I stuck to what I love to do.
Yo me quedé, o sea, me agarré a lo que me encantaba, a lo que me gustaba hacer.
And not necessarily conform to
y
what everyone else wanted from me.
Necesariamente conformarme con lo que la gente esperaba de mí.
And it has made me, I feel like it's made me stronger in my identity as a person.
Más fuerte en mi identidad como persona.
And as a musician.
Y como músico.
And yes, it's created a brand for myself.
Ha creado una marca para mí.
That I have an opportunity to enterprise.
De llevar a cabo como empresa.
I now have the opportunity
ahora
to make my own tours
hacer mis propias giras
and my own shows.
Y mis propios shows.
And it just shows you the power that we have today.
La fuerza de lo que tenemos hoy.
We don't necessarily need to be in a certain place.
Estar en un sitio en concreto.
We don't necessarily need to know a certain person
conocer a ciertas personas
anymore.
Ya eso se ha acabado.
Social media has given us the opportunity for the world to be at our fingertips.
Mundo esté a la yema de nuestros dedos.
It has brought me all the way here to meet you guys.
Hasta aquí, para que me veáis vosotros,
which I am so grateful for.
Que estoy tan agradecida por ello. Yeah, Taylor Gordon.
I'm going to eat up some more time. Any more questions?
¿Alguna otra pregunta? Había por ahí alguien arriba. Sí, venga. Hold it. It's right up there.
Para ti, ¿qué es lo que hace unos bateristas mejores que otros? Dentro de tu opinión.
In your opinion, what makes a drummer better than other?
Woo. Para mí personalmente,
o yo personalmente,
I think it's how they make me feel. I'm really attached to feelings. I'm born in July. I'm a Cancer. I don't know if you're into zodiacs, but we are very, very emotional.
And somos muy emocionales.
I don't think it's necessarily
no creo que what sea un,
I don't think it's necessarily what they play,
no lo que tocan,
but how it makes me feel when they play
it. Sentir cuando lo tocan.
And you know, one of my favorite drummers right now, his name is Nate Smith.
Su nombre es Nick Smith.
Nate Smith.
Oh, Nate Smith.
Have y'all heard of him?
¿Habéis oído? ¿Sabéis quién es?
He's quite amazing.
Es increíble, bastante increíble.
It's not like he's necessarily doing things that are the most advanced.
Que sean las más avanzadas o complicadas.
But when he does
it, cuando lo hace,
you know he means it.
Sabes que lo quiere decir.
You know?
Que él verdaderamente lo
siente. And that's what I search for.
Eso es lo que yo busco. Eso es lo que yo.
That's what I try to take a bit of his influence and put it in my playing.
Esas influencias y llevarla a mi forma de tocar.
I love Carter Beaufort.
Me encanta Carter Beaufort.
Who is the drummer for the Dave Matthews Band?
De la Dave Matthews Band.
And I love his musicality.
Me encanta su musicalidad.
I feel like his
siento que
the parts that he composed on the drum
que él compone
set
en la batería
made such a huge difference.
Hace tal diferencia tan grande
in how the song was
cómo
perceived.
La canción se recibe, se
so musicality,
así que la musicalidad,
groove,
el groove.
And I think after all those techniques,
después de todas esas cosas, la técnica,
even though technique is important, I'm not going to say that technique
la técnica sea importante, no voy a decir que no lo sea.
Because I was taught very good technique at a young age.
Yo tenía una buena técnica cuando era
pequeño. But I would say first and foremost,
pero lo primero y por encima de todo,
musicality is king.
La musicalidad es la reina. Principal, perdón. ¿Alguna otra?
Okay, one more. Maybe one or two more.
¿Alguna otra pregunta?
Sí. No sé, que nos explicara un poco cómo prepara un día de ella de trabajo, vamos, de estudio, cómo lo prepara, más o menos.
How do you prepare one day of work, maybe in the studio, maybe how do you prepare that, the work you're going to be doing?
I found the method where I use my iPhone. And if I have the music,
y si tengo la música,
I most of the time write down the form of the songs
escribo la forma de la canción
in my notes.
En mis notas.
And I note how many
y sé cuántos
bars there are in a verse
hay en la estrofa,
and how many bars there are in the chorus.
Compases hay en el estribillo.
Just so that I have a roadmap for
un mapa de carretera
the
para
recording or rehearsals.
Poder grabar o ensayar.
But I ultimately try to
pero
get it to a point where I have it memorized.
Tocar cuando lo que no he memorizado.
It involves very little
conlleva muy poco
playing.
Poco tocar.
I most of the time,
la mayoría de las veces,
if there is drums already in the song,
si la canción tiene batería,
I find ways to incorporate or complement the part.
O complementar esa parte.
If there is no drums,
si no hay batería,
I listen to the music around it
la música que está alrededor,
and think in my head what would sound most musical,
que sonaría más musical
as a listener.
Como escuchante.
So that's how I
esa
do
de
that.
La manera que yo lo hago. Beautiful.
One more.
Una más. Ese micro no estaba aquí en el monitor.
Hola. ¿Cómo te sientes al tocar la batería?
How do you feel when you play drums? Tricky question.
I guess.
Una pregunta
from,
muy
from
complicada.
The smile on my face, everyone tells it can
de
tell it brings me joy.
Que hay en mi cara, que todos podéis decir que me llena de felicidad, de alegría.
I think the best way to define
creo que la mejor manera para definirlo
is free.
Es libre.
It's one of the few times
de los pocos momentos
that most of my problems go away.
La mayoría de mis problemas desaparecen.
And I think about things that I love
cosas que amo,
and people that I love.
Gente que amo.
And I think about God.
Y pienso también en Dios.
And Yeah, that is mainly how I feel. I feel
Eso
free.
Principalmente, que me siento libre.
It's such a blessing to be able to have this to channel through.
Poder canalizar a través de esto.
And with that being said, I am going down to
esto,
close to 5 minutes and 30 seconds, and I will close out with another composition by the great Nico Yalassi. He's here today.
Está aquí hoy.
I would really like to thank him so much for allowing me to play his music.
Las gracias por permitirme tocar su música.
The song is entitled,
la canción se titula
A Quest for Pocket.
A Quest for the Pocket. La búsqueda del pocket. Taylor Gordon. We'll be right back.
Thank you so much, Seville. You're beautiful.
Muchísimas gracias a todos. Sois maravillosos.
I have one more minute.
I have a question.
Sure.
Okay. Yo tengo una pregunta porque el concepto de pocket, you know, the question. No sé si todos lo sabéis o lo conocéis. A mí siempre me ha confundido un poco. And I want you to define what is the pocket. Quiero que nos defina qué es el pocket. Ella es la reina del pocket. Pocket es el bolsillo, ¿no? Pero ¿cómo se relaciona eso con tocar la batería? How is related the word pocket with drumming? Or what is the meaning?
I'm trying to keep my definition consistent because
intento
you may
mi definición de forma consistente porque
be able to find it in multiple places.
Lo vais a encontrar en muchos sitios.
But in the past,
en el pasado,
and what I believe now,
y creo que ahora,
is that pocket is
pocket
the spaces in between
son
the notes.
Los espacios que hay entre las notas.
It determines how the music feels.
Y determina cómo se siente la música.
And it determines how people
y
move.
Determina cómo se mueve la gente.
And how people groove.
Y cómo la gente groovea. Beautiful.
Good enough, right?
Taylor Gordon.
Thank you.
Thank you, Taylor.
Thank you.
Thank you. Awesome. Let's hear it. Taylor Gordon, the Pocket Queen. Taylor Gordon, the Pocket Queen.